this live event here on ANC, the Department of Justice has dismissed the drug charges against Marine Lieutenant Colonel Ferdinand Marcelino. Let's get details. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Ina Reformina. What's the latest, Ina?
Yes, Cassie, we have this breaking news from the Department of Justice. The DOJ has dismissed the criminal case against Marine Lieutenant Colonel Ferdinand Marcelino. In a 16-page resolution exclusively obtained by ABS-CBN News, the DOJ, through Senior Deputy State Prosecutor Theodore Villanueva, said complainants Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, or PDEA, and PNP Anti-Illegal Drugs Group, AIDG, failed to provide sufficient evidence to pin down Marcelino and his informant and asset, Yan Yi Shu. The charges versus Marcelino and Yan for the manufacture, conspiracy to manufacture, and possession of illegal drugs were junked. It may be recalled, Kathy, that both were arrested last January 21st in Santa Cruz, Manila, in what authorities called a clandestine shabu laboratory. Marcelino, a known anti-drug crusader and former head of the PDEA Special Enforcement Service, and Yan, for their part, argued that they were in the subject townhouse for a legitimate anti-drug operation. The resolution said that complainants failed to present evidence, and I quote, to sustain a conviction during the trial on the merits of the case, end of quote. The DOJ said that evidence provided during the preliminary investigation of the case shows that, in a quote, before and after the issuance of a search warrant to conduct a search at the premises of Celadon residences, the two respondents were never seen during the casing and surveillance of the premises, end of quote, and that the search was precisely for different names or under Law Chi Atong Lee and a certain Chu. This supported Marcelino and Yan's claim that it was their first time in the subject townhouse and were there because they received information of an alleged illegal drug operation there. It is worth noting that as part of Marcelino's evidence, he presented an affidavit showing that PDEA Intelligence and Investigation Service Director Randy Pedroso confirmed that Marcelino coordinated with him regarding his surveillance activity in that particular townhouse at that particular time, as supported by the exchange of text messages. The DOJ also noted that it was established that Marcelino and Yan arrived at the premises at 10:20 p.m., followed by the PDEA and AIDG operatives at 10:22 p.m., meaning a difference of 2 minutes. This, the resolution said, ran counter to the allegation of complainants that Yan was even found on the second floor of the townhouse arranging plastic trays containing shabu because it was physically impossible for them to have been, for Yan, to be at the second floor if the difference between Marcelino and the operatives was just 2 minutes. The DOJ said, in a quote, the short gap of time and the absence of electrical power would very much hamper the movement of Marcelino and Yan to exercise control and dominion over the premises, end of quote. The DOJ said that while PDEA and the AIDG allege that Marcelino and Yan were in possession of illegal drugs, I quote, that is only their presumption based on the presence of respondents at the scene of the crime, which is not supported by independent evidence to show that respondents have prior actual knowledge that the house is a drug laboratory and contained so much drugs. The DOJ further said it was respondents' claim that they were, after all, in the location to verify if the house is a drug laboratory and to inform the proper authorities, in this case, the MBI, if their verification would yield positive results. The DOJ also noted that certification from the director of the National Bureau of Investigation, Virgilio Mendez, states that Marcelino is part of their operations against dangerous drugs, and even Marcelino's possession and Yan's possession of the key to the townhouse, a quote, the resolution cannot suffice to say that they had control and dominion over the premises. The DOJ said there should be prior overt acts of exercising control, administration, possession to show dominion over the premises and to whatever is found therein. Now, Kathy, the resolution also recommended the issuance of a release order for both respondents. Well, we know for a fact, of course, that Marcelino is already out on bail because the Regional Trial Court of Quezon City also granted his petition for bail on this particular case. A decision by the RTC, which Marcelino's camp says all the more bolsters his claim that there is no evidence to pin him down on these charges. And that is a breaking news from the Department of Justice, Ina Reformina, ABS-CBN News.
Thank you, Ina Reformina, joining us there live from the Department of Justice, which has just dismissed the drug charges against Marine Lieutenant Colonel Ferdinand Marcelino.